Dear graduates, on behalf of the faculty and staff members of the School of Health Sciences, congratulations on your accomplishments. Yes, this graduation day celebration is for you, yet it is also a landmark day for each of us, graduates, family, friends, and faculty members, to reflect upon and to give thanks. The women and men graduating today have each pursued their own personal journeys. And certainly, with the challenges of the major COVID-19 pandemic, there has never been a more meaningful time to graduate into a health-serving career. Yet, in the School of Health Sciences, we know that no person stands alone. We are, collectively, over 2,000 undergraduate, master's, doctoral, and post-professional students who, through expert faculty guidance and community partnerships, endeavor earnestly. Now, dear graduates, let us reflect. You are surrounded by friends and family, by companions, and virtually your now former classmates who are soon to be your future colleagues. And together you are to engage in the great enterprise of serving others. The world is in need. Our country is in need. All people, whether we meet them through the organized benefits of insured healthcare or do so in a haphazard fashion on the street in underserved communities. Yes, all people are in need of the help that you have learned to provide. Consider your vivid experiences within our School of Health Sciences. Was it by sleeping in a cardboard box one cold night, participating in our wellness and health promotion Fight the Night campaign, experiencing what it is to be homeless? Or was it by helping to assess and serve the health and social needs of our neighbors in poor urban communities? Might it have been through helping to provide disabled persons who could not afford care with free physical therapy services? Or was it by responding as the COVID-19 crisis began raging in Michigan to help package food for deliveries to communities in need? Together today, we mark your emergence as competent, collaborative, compassionate scholars and practitioners. You are ready. Draw upon the best of your now proven intellect. Give guidance and service through the best application of your clinical skills. Help others by learning what you don't yet know so as to refine your abilities, and make the best use of your leadership talents by first getting involved. And as you rise to meet all future challenges, please remember always to keep close for your support, your friends, family, colleagues, and indeed your School of Health Sciences academic family. For together we are at our best in purpose for health. Thank you.
Good evening. It is my distinct honor to introduce our commencement speaker, Ms. Telva Magruder. We are proud that Telva is the Vice Chair of the Oakland University School of Health Sciences Board of Advocacy and Resource Development. Ms. Magruder is General Motors' first ever Chief of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Officer, leading the organization's current diversity efforts to bring General Motors closer to their aspiration of being the most inclusive company in the world. Previously, Ms. Magruder served as General Motors' Global Director of Workplace Engineering and Operations Solutions, promoting sustainable workplaces across our globe. She has been an important part of the General Motors team for more than 26 years. Along with her professional accomplishments, Ms. Magruder is dedicated to teaching and leading others. Telva is the chairperson of the board of directors for the Girl Scouts of Southeastern Michigan. She serves on the advisory board for the University of Michigan School of Environment and Sustainability and is a board member for the organization Engineering Tomorrow. Ms. Magruder earned both her bachelor's and master's degrees in electrical engineering from Purdue University. She is a passionate leader, a positive driven individual with a keen sense of what is important. Without further ado, it is my honor to welcome Ms. Telva Magruder.
Good evening. I am humbled and grateful to be able to spend time with you as you walk into your future. Each and every one of you have chosen a path that allows you to directly influence the lives of those in our communities and possibly the world. And while one may argue that many career choices do that to some extent, I think it's fair to say that your direct influence is intentional and clearly correlated to social outcomes. That is an absolutely wonderful thought. So here you are, having reached one of your aspirational goals, and I ask you to keep a few things in mind. First, you create the future. Imagine three concentric circles nestled neatly inside of each other. Now, each of you put yourself in the center circle. Consider the next circle as context. The people and places that we interact with are that context. And then consider the largest circle as our culture. This concept makes you realize a few things. Your unique style, experiences, and expressions impact everyone else's context. That magnified effect in turn contributes to our culture, and our culture is a key driver for the future of caring, and indeed the future of everything. For that reason, with every decision that you make, born uniquely from your thoughts and your ideas, you can and do create the future. That may sound like a heavy burden, which brings me to the next point. Be yourself. Whether you're an introvert or an extrovert, a hockey player or a gardener, the best way for you to add value to any situation is to be yourself. I know this isn't new news, but it's surprisingly difficult for many people to do, particularly as we try new things. Our desire to fit into a norm and be accepted can often run against our desires to be strong contributors in our professions. Know that being yourself sustains your energy level, and your unique observations and ideas will naturally impact the world around you. You will navigate much more easily if you act from the inside out, rather than allow external factors to put you in a box or a maze. I'd like to tell you about one of my favorite books. It's called I Moved Your Cheese by Deepak Malhotra. And it's a story about three unique mics named Max, Big, and Zed. And they refuse to accept their life in a maze. Rather than running through the maze looking for cheese and accepting it as their destiny, Max, Big, and Zed explore the possibility that they can control how they experience the maze. And through that, they create outcomes that the other mice can never imagine. The maze is no longer even relevant to them. What they discover in their own unique ways is that the problem is not that the mouse is in the maze, but that the maze is in the mouse. The external, the maze, was confining their creativity, their passions, their belief in what was possible. And it was not until they let go of the traditionally accepted reality of the maze that they realized that their true power to change everything existed from within themselves. Their ability to change everything existed within themselves. And so I encourage you to be yourself, but at the same time, think about how much we're influenced by our paradigms and by the paradigms of others. And I'm sure that you've already had times in your life when you realized that you were thinking that what someone else was saying or doing was getting in the way of progress. We often must clear our preconceived notions of ourselves and of others and of things around us in order to have the ability to affect change and make progress. Those paradigms that I'm talking about are our own personal mazes that we hold and that others hold, and they prevent us from being our true selves and maximizing our collective potential. I encourage you to regularly confront your personal mazes so that you can fully express yourself and your ideas as you work with others to create the future of societal health. You know, this year we've seen walls of the mazes in our heads and in society come crashing down around us in the midst of a global pandemic. We have seen very difficult days, and we have seen astounding feats born of sheer necessity We're persevering in ways that we never imagined possible, and the world will never be the same. So that brings me to point three. With your newly certified skills and your passions, you are ready. You are ready. You're ready to pave a path aligned with upstream health and downstream care. Upstream to help lead our world in recognizing those in need, while promoting solutions to create healthy environments, and downstream, joining in the care of others through the giving of your health knowledge, talents, and skills. You are all problem solvers, and today you've all earned the ability to more directly influence the lives of those in our local communities and possibly throughout the world. You're focused on addressing social determinants of health and safety, and you believe in upstream health. I am so glad that you've accepted the challenge of influencing so many facets of health outcomes. There is no time like the present. So as you grow in your careers, I encourage you to always remember that you create the future, be yourself, and you are ready. Know that the courage to act must come from within. And if you feel stuck, remember that oftentimes the problem is not that the mouse is in the maze, but that the maze is in the mouse. Confront mazes in yourself and others and take positive action. You have so much to look forward to, and we have so much to look forward to. Congratulations. Be well, stay positive, and thank you for putting people first.
Hi, graduates. I am Dr. Jennifer Lucarelli from Interdisciplinary Health Sciences at Oakland University, and I am so thankful to be here today with you virtually celebrating your graduation. This is quite the accomplishment, and I hope that you are as proud of yourselves as all of your faculty here at Oakland University are. Go Grizzlies.
Hi, class of 2020. It's Dr. Kate. I wish you all a huge congratulations on an extraordinary accomplishment. You are bound for so much success.
Congratulations, all the School of Health Science graduates and all the other units as well. Good luck in your next phase.
Congratulations. This is Michelle Southward, the Director of Academic Advising and Student Services. I wanted to take the time out to send my warmest wishes to you all for much continued success. Again, congratulations.
Hi, School of Health Sciences graduate. My name is Nuvu, academic advisor, and I want to let you know that I'm super proud of you, and I would like to wish you the warmest congratulations on this huge milestone of yours. Go Grizzlies, congrats.
Congratulations, School of Health Sciences graduates. You did it. This is Lauren Levy, academic advisor. It was a pleasure working with some of you over the years. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. Congratulations.
Hello, I'm Dr. Chris Thompson from the Physical Therapy Program, Department of Human Movement Science. Congratulations to all the graduates, class of 2020. I hope you take some time to celebrate your accomplishment. I wish you all the best, personally and professionally. Go Grizzlies. Grizzlies.
Graduates of 2020, congratulations, you made it. Everything that 2020 threw at you, you knocked it down. This should give you the confidence to achieve all of your hopes and dreams in your future career. If you can handle 2020, you can handle anything. So go out there and save the world. Congratulations.
Congratulations, graduates. We are so proud of you. Go Grizzlies.
Hi, my name's Lori Hodorek, and we teach safety and first aid in the Department of Human Movement Science. We would like to wish all the 2020 OU graduates our best, and so get out there and save some lives.
Hi, I just want to say congratulations to all of our Oakland University graduates. I want to give a special shout out to our Public and Environmental Wellness Department graduates. Job well done.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. This has been an extraordinary year, and to your credit, you have succeeded in these unprecedented times. On behalf of the Environmental Health and Safety faculty, I wish you every success and all the best in your future pursuits.
Graduates of the class of 2020, congratulations on your outstanding achievement. This ceremony may not look the way you always thought it would, but you should be proud of where you are today. The class of 2020 will go down in history as a very special group of students who faced a great challenge. May the unique circumstances you found yourselves in this year inspire you to make the world a better place for generations to come.
Congratulations, your OU community, and in particular, your School of Health Science family, are proud of you. We'll always be here for you. We wish you all the best on your future endeavors, and please stay in touch. Take care.
Congratulations, graduates. This is Jessica Janman, adjunct professor of the Environmental Health and Safety Program. I am so grateful to have met and taught some of you over the past few years. I know you will do great things and wish you all the best. And go Grizzlies.
Congratulations to the graduating class of 2020. Your persistence, determination, and resilience will take you far in our professions. I believe you are ready for helping people, inspiring the world, and achieving your goals. Wish you all the best and congratulations again.
Congratulations, graduates of CDS and School of Health Sciences. Good luck with your future goals. We are proud of you, and you did it.
We are extremely proud of all of our new School of Health Science graduates for their incredible accomplishments. In this summer and fall ceremony, we are celebrating 272. With the Bachelor of Science degree, there are 213 graduates, the Master of Science degree, 10 graduates, earning the doctoral degree, 38 graduates, and earning graduate certificates, there are 11. And now, the recipients of our academic and leadership awards deserve some special recognition.